For me, soil health means being a good steward. It means taking care of the soil and not just coming out and dumping as much synthetic product as you can and using the soil as a conduit, more or less just to grow a crop, but to breed life back into the farm and build something that will last longer than just my career here on the farm. Hi, I'm Brice Armentrout. We're here at Kaler Family Farms. It's been in the family since the late 1830s. Right now we operate mainly in the Hog Creek watershed, and it flows on up to the Maumee River and ends up dumping into the Lake Erie Basin. I would say that the vision for this farm as I continue would be to somehow managed to carry it on and keep it going in the family. But also, as my ancestors did in the 1830s when they came here, it would be embrace diversity and innovation. Kind of mimic some of the things that they did, but with a newer twist on it, utilizing the technology we have today, such as no-till planters, cover crops, and chemistry as a way to control weeds instead of intensive tillage. For me, it was just trial and error and just getting my toes wet. I was lucky to have two older farmers in the area, one that was very heavily involved in conservation practices and is now retired, that, you know, I talked with him and he gave me the encouragement I needed. And then the other half was getting a better no-till planter to actually try things. And he did it on a small scale, and you kind of figured out what worked and what didn't work. And of course, we're always learning. So that's still something we do every year. Start small, try it on a couple acres, but make sure they're the same acres every year. That way you're not just moving your test around every year and not gaining any benefits from long-term no-till and conservation practices in general, and make it small enough to where if it hurts you, you don't have to just throw in the rag and go up to the house and quit. I would say just kind of taking it step by step and don't get discouraged when things go wrong, because even if you're a conventional farmer, things are always going to go wrong. Going down this regenerative path has been the equipment inventory, for one. I don't have near the equipment to maintain. I don't need multiple tractors. Everything takes a lot less time. I don't use near the fuel. I downsized tractors and planters, and I'm getting along just great with them because I don't have to make so many passes. Something I've noticed since I went down this path is a lot of the erosion seems, specifically the sheet erosion, doesn't seem as terrible as what it once was. Just the other night, I got out of the combine about 10 o'clock, and behind this building here, I got out and looked down the tree line, and I jumped out of the combine and thought I was seeing stars, and it was all the lightning bugs had come back. I've noticed a lot. I remember where you wouldn't hardly see any, but they actually made me feel like I was seeing stars for a minute, and I can't recall the last time that's happened for me. And just the amount of wildlife that's returned kind of validates in my mind that I'm doing something right, that something actually wants to call it home. I would like to be able to be here to help other farmers. I found that when I initially started off with this, I really had about two neighbors that were big influences for me. One had been no-till for 30 plus years and was doing a lot of cover crops. He took me to my first no-till and cover crop day at the Dave Brandt farm south east of Columbus. And then one of the other impacts that I had was one of the fellow farmers here in the advocate group. And I just feel that if you build a networking community and make it so more people feel more comfortable going out of their little comfort zone, that you'd be able to influence them more, but help them in a way that they don't get too carried away or get discouraged by some of the flaws they have, you can help them with. So I would say for me, I just like to be able to have people feel comfortable to call and talk with me and let them know, you know, what's worked and what hasn't worked for me. And also, it's a learning experience for me. I might learn something I hadn't thought of. And that's another great thing about this group, is it really opens up the doors to even for me to learn from it.